The East and West Coasts, or America in general itself, is a melting pot of different cultures, hundreds and hundreds of different nationalities and art, music, fashion. It's so diverse. I mean, although there's a major diversity among races in America, I mean, there are some parts of America that are predominantly of one thingy, you know? Man, did any of that make sense? America is all about food. Wherever you go, whatever block you're on, whatever road, whatever corner you're on, you will see at least 3 or 4 fast food joints, burger joints. I mean, trust me, people in America really freaking love their food. It's all about food. You got Wendy's, McDonald's, Burger King, and In-N-Out. You have all of that. I mean, they're all about that. In the West Coast, since it's really close to the border of Mexico, California is really famous for their Mexican food. And Mexican food is also pretty fucking bomb. That stuff's amazing. And in New York is famous for their pizza. They got bagels, they got pretzels. They're famous for that stuff. See, food is a universal language of happiness. Everybody can understand what that is. It's happiness, it's food. Come on, who doesn't like food? Food's fucking amazing, it's food. So, yeah. There's a very diverse food scene in the West and East Coast. And that is one of the reasons why Americans are really, really obese. Because food makes their world go round. That's the thing. It's all about food. And I don't blame them, because I also really, really like food. So yeah, there's that. It was the rap culture that highlighted the rivalry between the East and West Coasts. This was during the time of the golden age of hip-hop, when Notorious B.I.G. and Tupac had their beef. Down at Downey, a majority of the people there are predominantly Hispanic, while in Compton, a majority of the people are black. You see, there's a major diversity of races, and not just LA, not just in California, but in New York, all over the world. All over the U.S. The U.S. is very broad, and for the past century, the thing about speed racers is that they seek the adrenaline rush, the thrill of going really, really damn fast and avoiding law enforcement at the same time. That experience alone gives you an undeniable, unmistakable high, an adrenaline high. That is, people who speed race are thrill seekers. They thrive in such a stress-filled environment. For the past 60 years, fast cars and adrenaline have been ingrained in the American culture. Every car owner, at one point in their lives, has had the innate need to go fast. But sadly, the law doesn't always allow that, which is why cops are always a major factor in street racing. And that's how street racing came to be. People want to go fast. The law doesn't let you. You go fast anyway. You have a race. And if you're unlucky, the cops chase. Well, that's been part of American culture for years. People have been doing that for years.